new chairman, judges, all our honored guests. So, today, I will be discussing, as you can tell from my speech title, how to build a dinosaur. Now, this is Jack Horner, paleontologist, and he's really what inspired me to do this speech. He came up with most of this process, if not all of it, because he's always wanted to build a dinosaur. I'm sure a lot of you have also at least dreamt about having a pet dinosaur. So, first off, we do have dinosaurs. Chickens, birds, avian dinosaurs. They wake you up in the morning, they poop on your car. It's a real hassle. So technically, these are dinosaurs, but as Jack Horner puts it, that does not impress the sixth graders. So, one step towards a dinosaur is that chickens are, they don't really eat meat. I've seen them catch crickets and occasional lizard, but not like this Harris hawk here. They are predators. A lot of their hunting styles have been adapted from dinosaurs. And as you can see, it still does not look like a dinosaur. It's like this big. It has no claws. It barely even has a tail. It's like that long. So, we gotta get from that to this. This is an accurate representation of our knowledge nowadays of what a velociraptor or non-avian dinosaur looked like. Now, you can see it's got the full tail, it's got teeth, and it's got claws. It may be hard to see. So, my first process here is not this. This is an inaccurate velociraptor from Jurassic Park. But the process involved in Jurassic Park, I think we are all familiar with it. Dig in the ground, find amber, it's got a mosquito in it. Mosquito has dinosaur blood in it, supposedly. You whack a syringe in it, pull out the DNA, clone it, you have an island full to chase people with. So I think that the logical answer to this, if you did get DNA, viable DNA from a mosquito in amber and cloned it, so an entire island would be full of them. You would have an island of mosquitoes and trees. So, Jack Horner, being the person he is, wanting to build a dinosaur, thinks to himself, how can we make a dinosaur? Well, the logical answer, go to a dinosaur. So he did. He found a ton of T-Rexes, duck-billed dinosaurs, all that. And he has actually found hemoglobin, red blood cells, in fossilized dinosaur bones. But none of this had any DNA in it, so it's kind of a dead end. So, next he figured, well, if a chicken is a dinosaur, then there must be a way to get it to look like a dinosaur. Now, this is due to the fact that chickens are related to dinosaurs, and so he found out about atavistic genes. Now, atavistic genes are genes left over from one's ancestors, in this case a dinosaur, and they are turned on in the embryonic stages of development. So Jack Horner and his team had a look at a chicken embryo as it was growing. And turns out, it's growing a long tail. Problem is, you get these more modern genes and they basically tell the tail to stop when it's not even the tail yet. So, what he needs to do is he and his team figured out a way to turn off this gene, like a light switch. Flick it off and the tail can grow. This works with their claws and their teeth as well. So you end up with a chickenosaurus. Now, I'm not entirely sure if it is a non-avian dinosaur, technically, because it's still a chicken. It just got a lot of birth defects. So, as you can see, it's got a long tail, claws, and you probably can't see, it's got teeth. So that's basically what a dinosaur looks like. But there have been some recent developments, including an actual dinosaur snout and more terrestrial evolved feet, so they don't have to hang out in trees all day. Anyway, as you can see, that looks pretty close to a dinosaur. So, I would like to thank you all. Listen to my speech. If you have any questions, I'm free on the break. And thank you for listening to me talk about how to build a dinosaur.